So hello friends, so in this previous video I have already explained about spermatogenesis and oogenesis, and in this video I am just make a simple differentiate between spermatogenesis and oogenesis. That's why you have easy to understand what is spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Okay, so first spermatogenesis, then oogenesis. Okay, just I am simply differentiate these two things. Okay, in case of spermatogenesis, it is occurs in testis, and in case of oogenesis, it is the process which is occurs in ovaries. Okay, and the second point, the spermatogenesis, it leads to form male gamete, called sperm. Okay, and in case of oogenesis, it leads to form female gamete called ovum. Okay, then the third point, finally four functional sperms are formed from each spermatogonium. And in case of oogenesis, finally one functional ovum is formed from each oogonium. Okay, so this is the three points. Then next three points, the major difference between spermatogenesis and oogenesis. The fourth point is, numerous sperms formed by the process of spermatogenesis, that is numerous sperm. In case of oogenesis, there are limited number of ova formed. By the process of oogenesis. Okay, so the fifth point, thus in case of spermatogenesis, the sperms are formed and the sperms are small, elongated, active and motile. In case of oogenesis, the ova are large, rounded or oval or passive and non-motile. Motile means which is moved from one place to another place. In case of non-motile, it cannot move from one place to another place. Okay, then the sixth point between these two things, the sixth point is, this process complete in testis, and oogenesis, this process stops at secondary oocyte. Okay, then the seventh point, in case of spermatogenesis, nucleus become compact during spermatogenesis. nucleus becomes compact during this process. And in case of oogenesis, nucleus enlarge into germinal vesicle in ovum. Nucleus enlarges into germinal vesicles in ovum. And the last point of spermatogenesis, that is 8th number point, is discarding of considerable amount of cytoplasm occurs during maturation. And in case of oogenesis, cytoplasm increases by accumulation of yolk. Okay, so this is the major difference between spermatogenesis and oogenesis. So friends, this is all about spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Thank you.